Welcome back to the Sage Audio Channel. Today we're talking about how to master for streaming. But first, if you have a mix that you need mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com to receive a free mastered sample of it. What is loudness normalization? Loudness normalization is the method used by streaming services to make all tracks streamed on their service play back at just about the same volume. When you're mastering music, keep in mind how this is going to affect your track. Many services normalize audio to roughly -14 LUFS. This means that if your master is louder than -14 LUFS, like -10 LUFS, it'll get turned down by roughly 4 dB. So, if you've been mastering your tracks super loud and sacrificing your dynamics to do this, it helps to know that it's going to get turned down regardless. How loud should my master be? If your master will end up on a streaming service like YouTube or Spotify, use an LUFS meter at the end of your signal chain. This meter shows you the same form of measurement used by these streaming services. Now, although there is no exact target loudness that you should be aiming for, -14 LUFS to -8 LUFS is a good range for most genres. If you're mastering music that is often more dynamic, like folk, classical, or jazz, -14 LUFS is going to be loud enough. But if you're mastering rap, pop, or rock, something closer to -8 LUFS will work well. Typically speaking, the quieter the master, the more dynamic it'll be once it's been normalized. Don't make your master too dynamic. Because streaming services normalize audio, it can turn up audio past the point of 0 dB. Although this is rare, if your master is on the quieter side but still has large peaks, then these peaks can clip when the master is turned up by normalization. For example, if your master is -18 LUFS and you have a peak at -2 dB, then when the master's level is increased by 4 dB, that peak will be 2 dB over. Granted, streaming services account for this by using a limiter, but it's not great to rely on a limiter that you don't know the settings of or you can't control. How encoding affects streaming. Before your track is streamed, it'll need to be converted into a lossy file like an MP3 or AAC. This means that the WAV file that you created will be downgraded so that it's easier to be loaded. When your WAV file gets turned into a lossy file, the amplitude of your track can change by up to 2 dB. This means that if your master has peaks at nearly 0 dB, it can have its level increased, resulting in mild to significant clipping. To avoid this, reduce the level of your master by up to 2 dB true peak. This way, no distortion will occur if the amplitude is changed. A good mastering chain for streaming. Start with subtractive equalization to clean up the track. If you need to attenuate low frequencies, use a low latency linear phase mode. Next, use a little saturation to make it sound full by generating harmonics. Since we're going to avoid heavy compression and limiting later on, we'll use a low level compressor or maximizer to bring some of these subtle details forward. Since we're mastering, we'll need to use these plugins subtly, especially if we're working on a quieter genre. Next, use another EQ to amplify the details that you like, and maybe try mid-side and amplify the side image. End the chain with a limiter and your LUFS meter. If you have a mix, send it to us at sageaudio.com to receive a free mastered sample of it. Also, stay up to date by subscribing and liking the video. Lastly, let us know your thoughts in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching.